Hello and welcome. My name is Teacher Marcelo, and I'm going to be teaching you today about the Good Shepherd. So you may see that I'm wearing a costume. Can you guess what am I representing? Yes, I'm a shepherd. So as you can see, I have a few things here. Let's go through them. Here, can you guess what this is? Nice, you're on a good run. This is a headdress. Headdresses are used by shepherds to protect us from the sun. So, you know, you're always walking around in the desert, maybe in the farm, so you gotta take care of yourself from those rays. What about this? It's a staff, nice job. A staff it's really the key tool that we use. So it has multiple uses. One of them, for example, may be to take out the snakes that may be in the grounds from my sheep. Or I can even help my sheep that may have fallen into a hole, take them out by grabbing maybe their necks with this part. So I just pick them up and help them. And even to walk, I can use them to support myself around. Actually, being a shepherd is sometimes a hard and very lonely job, but really my interest is for my sheep to trust in me, and I always know that they're healthy. In the case of Jesus, he told us a story about that he was a shepherd, and obviously figuratively, we were the sheep, and he wanted us for us to trust him and for him to always know that we are healthy. Now, let's sing a worship song, and then let's learn about the story.
And all the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God, oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99, and I couldn't earn it, and I don't deserve it, still you give yourself away. And oh,
be reminded of this.
There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after you. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me.
No shadow.
There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. No wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me.
That's his heart.
There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. No, there's no shadow. Of God, oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99, and I couldn't earn it, and I don't deserve it, still you give yourself away, and oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love. Oh, there's nothing like your love, Jesus.
Jesus told a story to the Jewish leaders. If a person climbs into a sheep pen, he is not the shepherd, he is a thief. A shepherd enters the pen through the gate. When the sheep hear the shepherd's voice, they recognize him and follow him. A shepherd calls his sheep by name and he leads them. If the sheep hear the voice of a stranger, they will run away. The people did not understand Jesus' story. Jesus was talking about God's people as sheep. The Jewish leaders were the stranger, and Jesus is the shepherd. Jesus said, "I am the gate for the sheep. They come in through me and are saved." Jesus was saying that he is the gate that leads to true life. People who come to him are like sheep who come to green pastures. Jesus warned, "A thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy." Jesus was talking about the devil, who does not want people to follow God. Jesus said, "I have come so that they may have life. I am the good shepherd who lays down his life for the sheep," Jesus said. "I know my sheep, and my sheep know me." Like a shepherd risks his own life to protect his sheep from wolves, Jesus was willing to die for his people. Jesus came to do his Father's plan, and he was going to die and rise again. The Jews argued with one another. Many said, "Don't listen to him. He has a demon. He's crazy." Others said, "That's not true. How can a demon give sight to the blind?" The Jewish leaders asked Jesus, "Are you really the Messiah? Just tell us." Jesus answered, "I did tell you, but you did not believe because you are not my sheep. My miracles prove who I am." Jesus reminded them that he is the good shepherd. "My sheep hear my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they will never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. The Father and I are one." Jesus is the good shepherd. God sent him to rescue sinners. Jesus laid down his life for his sheep so they could have forgiveness and eternal life. When we trust in Jesus, we are his sheep who listen to, follow, and obey him.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Madeline from St. Paul, Minnesota asks,
"Why should we follow Jesus? Why can't we do whatever we want?"
Well, let me deal with that second question first, because I think it'll help us answer the first one. Why shouldn't we just do whatever we want? Well, here's the answer: because we don't know what's good for us. This is gonna be a cheery one, so just hang with me. The Bible says that our hearts are just broken completely. Our desires are flawed. We want terrible things for ourselves. We're selfish. We just wanna feed ourselves. We don't care about other people. I told you this is gonna be cheery. Hang with me though. So here's the reality. If we just did whatever we want, we would be a train wreck and other people would not like us very much because it would all be about us all the time. And God knows this. He knows that we're broken because of our sin. He knows that if he just let us do whatever we wanted to, it would be a mess, even more than it is now. God knows what we need better than we know. We gotta remember that. We think we know ourselves the best, but we don't. God knows us the best. And out of love, he gives us instructions on how to live. And if we follow his way and not our way, what happens is we experience the true joy that we've been longing for. We experience the abundant life that we really want and crave. It's all about dying to ourselves and living for Christ, which the Bible tells us to do. And so, do we really get what we want when we pursue what we want? No. But do we get what we need when we pursue Jesus? Yes. So that's the answer to your question, really. It's an act of grace and kindness that God gives us the better, the right way to live. So we should not give in to pursuing our own hearts. Our hearts will lead us astray every single time. We should pursue God's heart for us, and we'll have what we want, really, and we'll be used by God to bring others to Himself as well. So question, why is following Jesus better than following ourselves?
What a great lesson. The great part is that for us to know how much Jesus loves us and that we can recognize His voice. Now, let's play a game. It's called Name That Voice. We're gonna be hearing their voices, and your turn is for you to recognize them and see how many you can guess. Good, now let's listen to the first one.
It'll take him all day to figure this one out.
Let's repeat that again and see and try.
It'll take him all day to figure this one out.
I think I have a good idea. Maybe it's Bugs Bunny? Yes, that's the one. Nice job. Now let's try with the second one. Let's listen.
Oh, I don't know why, but I've always loved the idea of summer and sun and all things hot.
Really?
Did you guess it? I think I got it. It's Olaf the Snowman. So now, let's jump to the third one. Let's see who it is.
Rainbows are visions, but only illusions. And rainbows have nothing to hide.
Did you guess it? I got it. It's Kermit the Frog. And now, the fourth and the last one. Let's see.
His Holy Spirit in us, that He might guide us into all truth, that He might comfort us, that He might help us remember what it is that we've learned from the Scripture. So, compelling Spirit. The third one is...
Yep, I think you got it. It's Pastor Ben! Wow, you did an amazing job identifying all the voices. Now, are you able to identify God's voice? You are able to listen and read about God's voice through prayer, through music, through the Scriptures, and even from very trusted friends. We just need to listen to His voice and obey Him. You actually may have, you know, questions about all the things that we have gone through, and it's a great time for you to ask your parents as well. One question that I actually have for myself is, what can I do when I feel that God is far away from me? Now, let's pray. Lord, You're the good shepherd and we are Your sheep. When we foolishly wander away, you bring us back. You gave life up so that we can have eternal life. You even know us by name. When we feel lost or scared or alone, help us cry out to You. Help us listen to, follow, and obey You. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for joining us. Now, let's say goodbye by singing a worship song. We hope to see you next week at Epic Kids Online.